number to Jonathan Sotelo, my little brother. So I'm happy to stay here to see how to graduate something. So I'm very happy. All my family happy to Jonathan Sotelo.
Pues, mi hijo se llama Jesús Mora. Le deseo muchas felicidades y pues muchas gracias por todo lo que hizo en todo el año.
Hi, we're here for Juan Liberato and we're so proud of him. He's going to UCLA.
Hi, my name is Crystal Martinez and I'm here for the graduate Kenya Reyes. Congratulations, we're so proud of you, Kenya.
Like to say congratulations to Joshua Latrell Harris from his mother. I'm very proud of you.
And his father, Edgar Harris, very proud of him.
Yo quiero desearle muchas felicidades a mi hija Ángela María Navarro hoy en su graduación, que es un día muy especial para ella. Aunque ella sabe por qué, pero su papá está con ella. Y ojalá que desde el cielo le mande muchas bendiciones. Gracias.
Hi, I'm Ceci and I want to congratulate my brother David Pedroza for graduating and getting the Bill Gates Scholarship. Congrats.
Thank you.
Uriel, you're my best friend and I'm really proud of you. I hope you do well. I know you will. I'm really excited to come see you and just happy for you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am Mr. Ritchie, the very proud principal of Santa Ana Valley High School. I welcome the members of the Board of Trustees of Santa Ana Unified School District, our school district leaders, faculty, staff, parents, guests, and graduating seniors. This annual commencement ceremony for Santa Ana Valley High School. This time I'd like to welcome to the podium your Associate Student Body President, Jose Chavez Torres, who will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Can we all please stand?
We're getting blessed.
Place your right hand over your heart. Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Please be seated. Thank you, Jose. I'd like to begin by acknowledging our honored guests from our District Board of Education. We have Mr. Jose Alfredo Hernandez, member. Cecilia Ceci Iglesias, member. From our School District Central Administration Office, we have Dr. Rick Miller, Superintendent. Dr. Stephanie Phillips, Deputy Superintendent of Business Operations. Deputy Superintendent, Dr. David Hagley. Deputy Superintendent of K-12 Educational Services, Mark McKinney. Okay, I just said that wrong, didn't I? I apologize. I'm skipping things here. That's the Associate Superintendent of Human Resources. We have Doreen Lonis, Assistant Superintendent of Support Services. Dr. Michelle Rodriguez, Assistant Superintendent of K-12 Teaching and Learning. Tina Douglas, Assistant Superintendent of Business Services. Lucinda Pueblo, Assistant Superintendent of K-12 School Performance and Culture. Oren Williams, Assistant Superintendent of Facilities and Governmental Relations. We also have Principal Lisa Solomon of Madison Elementary. Also seated on the platform with us is Valley's Associated Student Body President, Jose Chavez Torres. The senior class president, Jesus Jimenez. Uriel Oropeza has the distinction of sitting on the platform as the class valedictorian. And joining him is our salutatorian, Roxanne Martinez. Sitting with the students are many of the proud members of the Valley High School faculty, guidance, and administrative teams. I know we also have our orchestra director, Joaquin Hernandez, and choir director, Jessica Copley. At this time, I'd like to announce school board member, Mr. Jose Alfredo Hernandez, to share a few words.
Good afternoon, graduates, family, and friends. Welcome to the commencement ceremony for Valley High School 2016. Padres de familia, bienvenidos a esta ceremonia de la graduación de sus hijos. Pero antes de que comience a dar un pequeño discurso, me gustaría que si pudiéramos observar un segundo de silencio para las víctimas de la tragedia que ocurrió en Orlando. I would like to begin my address by asking you to join me in a moment of silence for the victims of the terrible tragedy that occurred in Orlando. If you could please. Thank you very much. It is truly my privilege to be able to address you here today. Now, while I'm asked to speak because I'm a member of the school board, I want you for one moment throughout this speech just to ignore that fact. And I'd ask you to look at me as for who I truly am. Now, what does that mean, you might ask? Well, the answer is quite simple. I am one of you. And just like you, I grew up here in Santa Ana. Just like you, I completed my entire high school education in Santa Ana. Like many of you, I'm an immigrant. Or in the case of others, a son of immigrants. You and I are sons and daughters of this city, this wonderful city of Santa Ana. Why is that important? Why does it matter? I don't know that it's important, and I really don't know that it matters. But what I can tell you, though, is that 24 years ago, I sat where you sit here today. I was 17 years old, about to turn 18. I was ready to take on the world. And like many of you, I had my life full of hopes and dreams. You know, I had some lofty dreams. I wanted to go to UCLA. I wanted to get a law degree. And I had some silly dreams. You know, I had gone to Dodger games, but I sat in the teacher. So I wanted to be as close to the action as possible, right? Oh, and I even had some stupid dreams. You know, I was in the counselor's office one day. I saw a big poster that said justification for a higher education, and there was a nice black Porsche, sports car, right there, and I was dreaming, oh, I wish one day that I could drive this car down the highway going 100 miles an hour without getting caught by the police. Whether you admit it or not, each and every one of you has dreams of your own as you sit here today. And graduates, I'm here to tell you, as a simple son of the city of Santa Ana, that you have been empowered to achieve those hopes and dreams. Thanks to the teachers that sit behind you, to the support that's been provided by friends and family and all of your parents, you have that opportunity. Now you can achieve anything you set your mind to. Some of you have already begun to take advantage of this opportunity and every opportunity that has been given to you. Many of you are well on your way to find institutions of learning. Many of you will be serving our military and our country, while others will immediately join that workforce. But graduates, you all have one thing in common. You have the ability to choose your destiny, to create your own path. Whatever path you do choose, it will be filled with obstacles and challenges. And unfortunately, or fortunately, you will be defined by how you handle those obstacles and challenges. Will they prevent you from fulfilling your dreams, from achieving your goals? Or will they be merely a part of that story of what you overcame to achieve your dreams? You cannot idly stand by and wait for good things to happen. Oh no. You must rise up to that challenge and take what you want. And don't let anybody tell you that you can't achieve what you want. Each and everyone should live a life. You don't want to live in existence. You just don't want to be here. And I'm going to leave you with this quote from Mahatma Gandhi. Live as if you are going to die tomorrow, and learn as if you are going to live forever. Congratulations, graduates. Thank you, Mr. Hernandez. And next, I'd like to bring to the podium school board member, Ms. Cecilia Ceci Iglesias.
Falcons. I can't hear you, Falcons. I am so honored to be here today, and I am so very proud to be here among you. I don't know if you guys know, but I'm also a Falcon. Many, many moons ago, though. But I am also, you know, you guys, Valley High School is so dear in my heart that every time I have an opportunity to come and speak to you or come and visit your Valley High School, I'm always honored and humbled. I grew up here in Santa Ana, too. I have many of you who are my friends and my family members. and that you guys have been an opportunity of support for me, and I hope that I have been in support to you too. I just want to let you know that this is only the beginning. Many of you may think it's, you know, it's the end, but it's an end to a chapter of your life, but it's a beginning to a new chapter of your life. How many of you guys are going to college? How many are going to Santa Ana College? That's awesome, because you guys know, right? It's free tuition for the, awesome. So you guys, I hope that we're able to provide that added support for you while you guys go on to college, wherever you may go, wherever your career takes you. My hope is always that you guys go out there and come back and serve Santa Ana. Because we are here because you guys have allowed us an opportunity. So we hope that we have given you that opportunity to fly away, but eventually we hope you guys come back. I just want to also thank the parents. Parents, thank you for giving us an opportunity here at the Santa Ana School Board and the district for entrusting us with your most prized possession, which is your children. I hope that we have served you well, and I hope that we continue to be in support of you in regarding your child's successful education. And I hope that you're able to count on us, because like I said, it's only the beginning for them when it comes to their professional life, and we are here to continue that support until they come back to us and they serve here in Santa Ana. So I would want to say these words in Spanish, if I may. A los padres, gracias por estar aquí y por darnos la oportunidad de servirles a ustedes. Gracias por el honor que nos dan con la confianza de poner el futuro de sus hijos en nuestras manos. Espero que les hayamos servido bien y espero también que tengan la confianza de venir y seguir pidiendo apoyo si lo necesitan, porque eso es nada más el comienzo a su carrera profesional. Y esperamos que nosotros podamos seguir siendo esa fuerza de apoyo para ustedes. So que Dios los bendiga a todos y estamos aquí para servirles. Y recuerden, nosotros trabajamos para usted, okay? So we work for you. That's one thing that I want you guys to know, is that we work for you. So whatever it is that we can help you with, you guys feel comfortable to come and tell us. At this point, I love all of you guys. You guys are all amazing. You guys look all amazing. Very proud of you. But I want to share my appreciation to one of my family members, which is, she's in the audience right now. Her name is Heidi Padilla. If you could please get up. My niece, I'm very proud of her because, you know, she's gone so much. She's just like you guys, we're all immigrants. We're all here together, and I hope that she's been a support to you guys. And, you know, she's not only my niece, but this is all for you guys. So I'm going to do something that Mr. Palacio always does. I want all of you guys to rise. Turn to your parents and give them a round of applause. That day, this is your day. Congratulations, class of 2016.
Thank you, Mr. Glacier. Would you welcome to the podium Superintendent Dr. Rick Miller to share a few words of inspiration.
Good afternoon. It's certainly my pleasure to be with you this afternoon as we celebrate your graduation. You're part of this graduation because you've worked hard, you were thoughtful, and ultimately you persevered. That is, you kept going when other people stopped. I understand that the main event this afternoon is your receipt of your high school diploma and the celebration with your friends and family. However, before we go there, I would like to congratulate you, the class of 2016, for the tremendous work you have done at Valley High School. You as a class have accomplished so much through your work and diligence. I'm sure that your principal and others will go through all the statistics, but some of the highlights I see are last week, your culinary arts team, supported by High School Inc., went to Washington, D.C., and they won the national title. Great job, ladies. At the beginning of this same month, June, your automotive team went to Sacramento and they played second in the state, which qualified them for nationals in November. But beyond that accomplishment, they were also first place in character, at least in my view. They saw their students that were in need. The automotive team pooled their resources, they motivated others to help, and ultimately they made sure that others were taken care of. And throughout, your high school, Valley High School representative to my student advisory group, Adriana Herrera, keeps me informed about the activities and success of Valley High School. One out of three of you has the seal of biliteracy. That signifies you have demonstrated competency in two or more languages. Your top students academically have scholarships and are attending top universities in the United States, such as Notre Dame in Indiana, UC Berkeley, UC Santa Barbara, UC Davis, UCLA, USC, Cornell in New York, Harvard in Massachusetts. Two of you have Gates Millennium scholarships that will pay all of your expenses for the next 8 to 10 years should you pursue your doctorate degree. You are an accomplished class that has set the bar high at Valley High School for those that follow. The reality is, for you and for all of us, you're not defined by where we come from or what we've done. We're defined by who we are and where we're going. It's your choice and you're the magic. So the question this afternoon is, where are you going? And only you get to make that decision. Author Angela Duckworth shared that grit is sticking with your future day in and day out. Not for just a week, not for just a month, but for years. Grit is living life like it's a marathon, not a sprint. Congratulations, class of 2016, and best wishes.
Thank you, Dr. Miller. Would the senior choir members please join their colleagues on the rising?
Oh,
It is my honor to present your 2016 valedictorian of Santa Ana Valley High School, Mr. Uriel Oropeza.
All right. You guys ready? Good evening, Superintendent Dr. Rick Miller, Board of Education members, Principal Ritchie, Valley teachers and staff, our supporters that have made it the time to be with us here today. Now, before I begin, I would like to give a huge thank you to those that helped me put the speech together. My dog, Lily, Microsoft Word, Ellen DeGeneres, Emma Watson, Emma Stone, John Green, Ms. Gibbs, and especially ValedictorianSpeeches.com. A special thank you to those that helped me shape me to who I am today. Lily Morena, my friends, my mentors, Alexis, Sears, Edgar, my mentors, my parents. Gracias, Mom. Gracias, I los quiero mucho. My brother, my sisters, and especially you guys. Valley seniors, this is for you. Dear class of 2016, life, man. We have all asked ourselves, what is my purpose? What is the meaning of all of this? Why in the world am I here? Before I share with you all the small pieces of my so-called wisdom, I'd first like to share this with you. You are unique. Like, literally. The probability of you existing as you in terms of same height, sadly, eye color, smile, and in general, your unique human genome is about 1 in 400 trillion. In other words, you are far much more likely to win the lottery than to be the person you are today. And I think we all won at that. And today, we are here. We made it to quite a lot. Girls, you survived your funny duckling pictures from MySpace? Well, most of you did. Guys, we didn't work on our six-packs as much as we wanted to, unless you're Ernie Rios. But for those of you that do have a six-pack, come talk to me after you see. You survived a series of explosions in your life. One being our very own Falcon at our gym. You survived 2012, the year we all thought we were going to die. And Ebola, and thanks to the FBI, we survived all of them. Who remembers that, yeah? Yet still the question remains, why you? As some of you may know, I tend to be a really happy person. And in general, I look at the positive aspects of my life. And this doesn't mean that I ignore the bad. But have you ever thought to yourself that sometimes bad things are good? Think about it like this. If sadness does not exist, how will you know that you're happy? Or excited? Or joyful? We all face hardships. We all face successful moments. Weird moments. Once in a lifetime moments like right now. We have all just thought about any other feeling you can think of. But even though we may feel these similar moments, we still differentiate from ourselves and one another. I know that we're all expecting a message of how from now on you'll be sent to the real world, but truth is, the world has been real to all of us all along. We, kids from Santa Ana, have lived through things that the real world holds. The world that we have lived in for the past set of years is the real world. And what the future holds is what we make it to be. From this day on, we will all experience sadness, we will all experience happiness, rejection, we'll all be lost all over again. But it's okay. You just have to find your second wind, like Jonathan Goldman says. Yet whether it is work, college, a gap year, or just some time to figure things out, the beauty of that is that you and now have some control over what your future will hold. And if there's anything I can share with you that I learned about being 5'2", or 5'3", depending who's asking, it is that you have to dream bigger than you will ever will be. Now, I will give you my answer. And this doesn't mean that you have to agree, but as of today, the 7-year-old version of me, this is my answer to the question, why in the world am I here? I am here because I know that even though the Andromeda galaxy is predicted to pass into our galaxy, the Milky Way, and eventually bringing our Earth to an end, I'm here to notice the beauty of what my life has now. And beauty has to do so much more than the body. Beauty is imperfection. Think about it like this. That girl that you touched on is so beautiful to you, she's perfect. So if she's perfect, then everyone else should be imperfect. Meaning that an imperfect pool, you found an imperfection within itself that was beautiful. All of our worlds are different. You control what yours is like. If there's something that the world isn't doing, do it yourself. Ask yourself, what can I do to make this world a better place? And as a result, a better world for me. You all have a talent, thus, you all have a capability. And I know that you're afraid of change. Though I don't know the future, I didn't come here to tell you how this is going to end. I came here to tell you how it's going to begin. I wanted to show all of you that even if we don't have the power to choose where we come from, we can still choose where we go from there. I'm going to show you all the world without limits. A world where you rule and control. A world without borders, boundaries, or walls. A world where anything is possible. Where we go from there is a choice I leave you. Why am I here? I'm here because I found beauty in the life I live. I'm going to make this world a better place. I'm here to be happy and to inspire those around me. Why are you? Thank you.
Thank you, Uriel. Another honor bestowed upon me is the opportunity to introduce the 2016 salutatorian of Valley High School, Ms. Roxanne Martinez.
Good evening. Let me begin by saying that I am humbled and honored by the opportunity to speak to you today. I would like to express my deepest gratitude to all the administrators and faculty who have poured their heart and soul to making us better and more civilized people. To all the parents who have devoted long years of their lives into what seems to be the world's most thankless job, at least in my parents' case. Mama Bear, Papa Bear, Yogita, quiero tomar este momento para agradecerles por todo lo que han hecho por mí. Quiero que sepan que todo mi esfuerzo y mi trabajo es solo una reflexión de lo que ustedes me han demostrado. Los quiero mucho y gracias por todo. Fellow seniors, family, faculty and friends, as I was getting ready this afternoon, I realized that today is the day. Today is the day that I will walk across the stage with the class of 2016 and will finally be receiving my diploma. As we stand here today on the precipice of the future, it's not a distant reality anymore. It begins here. It begins today. We began high school as children, but we're leaving here as adults. We completed a foundation education that will serve as a platform we use to launch ourselves into our future. Some of us will go into college. Others will go straight into the workforce. But each of us will have our own path. No matter where we go or what we do, there are challenges ahead of us. What I'm asking from each of you and from myself is to meet those challenges straight on, with your head held high and your heart wide open. You must try to excel in everything you do, strive for excellence in every task, large or small. As a class, we have already demonstrated these characteristics. The students in the High School Inc. Academy who have received a certification. The students who have been admitted to the College of the Dream. For all the athletes who won league and are made it to CIS in their respective sports. And especially for the students who will be the first in their family to go to college, and some will be the first in their family to graduate high school. Although I know it may be easy to see, every accomplishment you see is added to the world's accomplishment. Your individual successes benefit society as a whole, because when you succeed, you lighten the burden on your fellow man. When you succeed, you're in a position to give rather than take. We may not have the power to inspire the entire world to strive for success, but we do have the power to try to achieve it for ourselves. The future is still in our hands. Let's make the most of it. Congratulations, class of 2016. Oh, wait. I want to give a special shout out to my squad. Love you guys.
Thank you, Roxanne. Over the past several weeks, I have written two amazing speeches. Just ask me, I'll tell you they're amazing. They didn't have that punch I was looking for, and they didn't seem to have that motivational impact required for an amazing speech, so they weren't so amazing, and I tossed them. So often we write something, we look for certain resonating words, some nuggets of wisdom, inspirational quotes, future forward language. And the problem is the written word can get farther and farther away from the personalized or from the heart version, the one you intended. So I mixed it up. I thought much about the relationships I've developed with many of you, and I wanted to personalize it. So the good news, I'll keep it short. I know you're thinking about a party when we get through here, so stay focused with me, please. So what I finally settled on, I want to talk a little bit about value statements, those statements that were developed based on voices from you, the students, your parents, staff, and the community. At first, we are connected. You've been supported by your family, teachers and counselors, mentors and friends. You have a network of connectedness. You've certainly been connected to Valley through athletics. Raise your hand if that fits. Yes. Let's see a raise of hands for those that participate in ASB or club participation anyway. How many of you are involved in the High School Link Academy? What about the Amphitheater Academy? How many in dance, choir, or orchestra? Any of you connect with the Knack or Falcon Club? I'll bet you're connected to each other through social media. Anyone? So, we are connected. But second, we are lifelong learners. We learn in the classroom, and we learn outside the classroom. We learn from each other. We learn from family. We learn when we listen. I know that I learn from you. Your stories teach me about empathy, about culture, understanding, tolerance, and much about strength. I think of the relationships with many of you and the success stories I hear about. There's great learning in that for me. I learn from the faculty and staff. I learn, and so should you. Continue. Your mission, should you choose to accept it, is to continue your learning. Make it a habit. If you ever think you know it all, you've stopped learning. So, we are lifelong learners. The third, we are strong. Said another way could be, we are unstoppable. I think that's a fair depiction of many of you. And Valley Seniors, you're resilient. You've overcome obstacles and barriers that many simply can't, yet you're still seated here and you're waiting for me to stop talking. There's resilience. You are strong. You're tough with what I might call street smarts. You're tough with what I would refer to as book smarts. Most of you are bilingual in some capacity. You are incredibly strong. How many seniors in this country are prepared for this world as you? I'm telling you, not many. Please, be confident in your strength. Know who you are. You are an amazing group of students that will go far if you believe in that strength. We are strong. Last, we are Valley. You represent the Valley community. You have helped build Valley pride. There are so many accomplishments, and I apologize for not naming them all. We do not have time, and I know we talked about that graduation party that you want to get to, so we won't name them all. But here's a few of the many accomplishments I'd like to share. We have two Gates Millennium Scholars, Mr. David Pedroza and Uriel Pedroza. We have for the fourth time, the culinary team who has won national champions, which is represented this year by Rosa Aguilar, Maria Macias, and Daisy Laguna. Great. We have two league MVPs, Roxanne Martinez in basketball, and Alejandra Barajas in water polo. Felix Slias and Carlos Sultana took fourth place in the Okada Automotive Competition this year. Peter Coffinger from the Marching Band received Superior Awards in the Percussion Solo and Ensemble category. Rosa Vasquez, Carlos Gonzalez, and Adriana Herrera for their admission into Ivy League schools of Harvard and Cornell. 14 varsity athletic teams that qualified as CIF academic champions. Valeria Sanchez for coming to Valley as a newcomer and exiting college bound. 44 students that completed high school with at least a 4.0 GPA. And get this, Alex Molino, Daisy Lagunas, and Cesar Martinez for 4 years of perfect attendance. Yeah. 90% of you that are pursuing a 2 or 4 year degree, you should be congratulated, 90% of you. And listen, so much more. For graduating seniors, I ask, who are you? Congratulations, class of 2016. As I prepare to present the 2016 graduating class, I'd ask that Mr. Hernandez, school board member, join me at the podium. Mr. Hernandez, by authority vested in me by the Santa Ana Board of Trustees and by the certification of the faculty at Santa Ana Valley High School, I do hereby affirm that all requirements set forth by the Board of Education of the Santa Ana Unified School District have been met by these seniors. And I therefore confer the high school diploma on the class of 2016 with all the rights and privileges thereto attached. Mr. Hernandez, member of the Santa Ana Unified School Board of Education, I'm honored to present to you the Valley High School class of 2016. Yeah!
Thank you, Mr. Ritchie. By the authority vested in me by the Santa Ana Board of Trustees and by the certification of the faculty at Santa Ana Valley High School, I do hereby affirm that all the requirements set forth by the Board of Education of the Santa Ana Unified School District have been met by the seniors and confer the high school diploma on the class of 2016 with all the rights and privileges thereto attached. Congratulations.
This time I'd like to ask the teachers that have been chosen by the seniors to whom have the honor of reading the senior names to report to their respective podiums. Honored guests, please prepare to greet the graduates and students on the platform. Please join the platform. Let's get to the good stuff, folks.